And as usual, we're at Afsana Beauty Salon trying to get all dolled up. If you don't like this, then I don't know exactly who you're looking at. Welcome to Salon Talk. My name is Judithiana. And guess what? On today's show, I have the dancehall queen, the Uganda dancehall queen. She calls herself Cindy, baby. We're going to talk about everything from her taking someone's man, from her new bush. She's glowing. She's looking so fine. This man must be doing exactly what he's supposed to do. And our topic today, we're going to talk about women who use witchcraft in their relationships and marriages to maintain them. As in, yeah, she didn't cook beans and there's no a pinch of her urine. I talked to Mama Fina. She told me, you girls go and tell her that you want to maintain those marriages and relationships. Why do you do it? We're going to get to the bottom of that on today's show. It's Salon Talk. Hi, Cindy.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm good.
You're
how are
glowing.
You?
Glowing.
Thank you.
Did you have some before you came here?
Would I tell you? I would never tell.
First things first. Your man is fine as wine.
Yes.
He's fine. He goes to the
Let's
gym
not
regularly.
Talk about that. I will talk all day. Well, he is a sportsman.
He goes to the gym. Oh, yeah, he's a footballer.
It's his life. So, like, stuff like a six-pack and abs just come naturally.
So, when he's out of the bathroom, you're like, my baby, take a quarter well.
It's okay. I can't get many.
Can you imagine? Okay, now I want to be you. I want to be you. First things first, I know you're happy now, but let's get back to this. Okay, it's not sad, but you know what? It was
to the past.
It happened. And most probably you learned something from it.
Absolutely.
Marriage.
Yes, yes.
What happened? That was a gorgeous boy as well, Cindy. Yes, what happened? How could you let that go? Girls are fighting to get white men.
Well, gorgeous can only get you close to the person. It doesn't keep them there, you know? You
yes,
can't
true,
just stay
true,
with someone
true.
Because they're gorgeous. Now, when I met him, I was 19. I'm 29 now. So it's, I grew up.
So, okay, we can't get into everything.
Yeah.
But we read so much. Everybody read everything.
Yes.
He says you were not good in bed. Were you not giving him or you were just not giving? You didn't put any emphasis, as in you didn't give it your all.
Sweetheart, he was there for 10 years.
Okay.
What yeah. was he doing there for 10 years?
If it wasn't that good.
I'm not his sister, so...
I like that.
No, men say stuff when they're disappointed or they're upset. They will say things just to get to you. So, you know, he will say whatever he has to say, but I know we had
you
a good
time. You were rocking
time.
It.
Yeah, baby. Trust.
Because this was other girls that were coming in. Would you say he got to a point where he got bored of the relationship?
No, actually, it wasn't about him. I left the relationship.
You were
yes.
tired.
Yeah, no, it wasn't going anywhere. I can't say it was about I got bored.
He didn't put a ring on it.
He didn't put a ring on it, so it wasn't going anywhere.
And
after 10 years and a baby and all, so I was like, what are we doing? You
At
know?
Least what's your plot of land over? What are you
going to be? I'm not talking about that.
Quickly, there's so many Ugandan girls who like white men.
Mm.
You've dated a black one and now you're head over heels.
I am dating a black one.
And change then you've dated, yes.
Rephrase.
It out. Black don't crack.
What is this supposed to mean?
So between white and black, what you've tested, you're testing, or you've tested both. Tell us, what's the difference?
We are really talking about
yeah,
this.
Yeah, of course, we're in a salon. What else? Do you want me to ask you about your career? I'm sorry. I'm not going to ask about that. What's the difference?
Well, the difference is that white people are more emotionally open than black people. That applies in every aspect of their lives, whether it's sex or it's just saying hi or
the hopeless romantic.
General, yes, they wear their hearts on their sleeve. So if they love you, they love you. If they feel like saying that on top of a mountain, they will say that. They won't think, what do you want to do?
Of course, what do you want to turn over?
Exactly. All of the things, they won't think about it. That affects every aspect of their lives. Kati, our men,
Our men are told them such that takola chi takava you know, even if you feel something, all that stuff. So that is the difference. That's black men are probably shy about certain things. Mm-hmm. They won't talk about, you know, they won't do certain things. And then white people is just like, I want to do this, I do this.
Okay.
You know, like
bedroom. Comparison. Tiambeko. Yeah, you help the young girls. Do you know how many girls fight over these white men?
I know.
There's a line.
I know.
So, comparison. White men and black men, who gets it down better?
This is the thing that I can't compare. You understand? The only difference. Can you see me?
Yes, you I can see you, honey. The only difference.
It's, that's why I said it affects every aspect of their lives. Because if somebody is emotionally open, they will be
they'll
more
give
open
themselves
even
to
towards,
you.
Even in sex, yes, even in yes. conversation, in everything. So when somebody is more open, they explore more. Yes. So on together. Yes.
You're Cindy, baby. Why Fina Masanyaraz's ex? Was it current? Was it ex? Okay, clear the air. Number, tell
me. I don't care who his ex is. It could have been anyone. It could have been some, you know, I don't know, Namutebi from Kaboja or, you know, from, I don't know, some village. Yeah?
Yes.
And I wouldn't care because his past really doesn't matter to me. So it's not like I picked, like, oh, I want somebody who had a celebrity before. No, I didn't really care. And then when I met him, according to what I know.
First of all, before you actually go, honey, you didn't give your time to self, you didn't give yourself time to heal. As soon as this was done, you were like, honey, let's get it on.
There was nothing to heal about.
Well, you were
no,
violent.
Like, there was nothing to heal about. Like, I knew I was done. And that was it. There was no reason for me to sit around, cry, and think about it. No, I'd thought about it. It
and you
was,
were done.
Yeah, it had started to be over 2 years before I left. You understand? The relationship just kept. I kept thinking, okay, this is not what I want. This is not what I want. I'm like, okay, yeah, bye. So
how did you meet Ken?
After a show.
Were you influenced with this whole South African best? For some reason, every celebrity's mind is South African best tycoon, South African
when,
best footballer.
When I met him, I actually had no idea who he was.
You just saw a fine-looking man, like
no,
come here,
like, my friends were going to hang out. They said, one of my dancers is his friend. So I said, I'm going to hang out with my friends. Do you want to go out? That day after the show, usually after the show, I have so much adrenaline that I can't sleep. I want to kind of blow it off somewhere.
Okay.
I want to go and dance it away have a drink or so. Mm. So when she suggested, I said, yeah, okay.
Sure.
Let's go out. Sure, why not? So I went out and then I met this guy.
And you guys, that's where it began.
Well, that's when I met him. Not
okay.
when it all started.
Okay.
Yeah. No, I'm not that kind of girl.
Okay.
Not the first night.
How long did it take? 2 days? 5 days? A week?
A week, 2 weeks. I love 3 weeks. This.
So then Fina starts to say, because you see, I've watched a few interviews of her.
Yeah.
Where she said, Zomsaja tanchawa and got but Zomsaja liwoku sajalata. Meaning?
That is a miserable statement.
Yeah,
that is a really miserable statement.
Like, what's the dealio?
I don't know what's the dealio with her. Like, I wouldn't ever let
Cindy, what would you think if I advised you as your girl?
Yeah.
To just go sit down with lady to lady in a mature talk.
Mm.
You're like, honey, this is how things are. He told me. Because at sometimes they call us homewreckers.
Yes.
Sometimes it's by default because they're too hot.
Mm.
Sometimes... because he's not a cup.
That's true. To be
as
one
in you didn't
or
go and lift him no mutuala. He
he's
wanted
like some
to.
Fridge that I went to her house and I stole it, you know, and it has no say. It's in my house. Nobody can take it out.
So are you sure it's over? What's the situation
between
you, Ken and Fina?
Fina is not an issue in our relationship, like at all. Apart from, of course, in her mind.
So what's it about Ken? You are gushing about him on your Facebook page. I was like, this is for real. It's not for joking. What? Okay, apart from him being fine, yeah, we get it. What else? He texts you out shopping. Yes.
I'll tell you one thing. Money does not impress me because I make money. I'm a millionaire on my own. That's just the truth.
Booyak.
I'm not trying to blow, you know, my own trumpet. That's the truth. So money is not really something that, you know, gets me off my seat. It's just other things, just being nice.
He's nice.
You know, he's very nice. He's kind. He's generous. He's sweet.
I like generous. Generous men, yes, I like.
Yeah, so he's just different, you know. Before Mario, I dated another white man as well.
Oh.
So you understand.
Now you're testing the real African meal, the real tradition, the main course.
I'm not testing. I'm having it, baby.
In full.
I'm not testing. I'm 29. I have no time to taste.
One thing I've loved about you, all the ladies I've hosted here, including me, myself,
yeah,
no one is so open about their age, though. And you are.
I love
my age. Is it because you're looking nice compared to you?
Well, I am lucky. I do look at myself sometimes. I'm like, okay, we are doing well. I give myself a pat on the shoulder. Like, we are doing well. I try and take care of myself, so I'm not scared of my age.
Where do you see it going with Ken?
Hopefully, it will go far. We've been together since January, end of January.
Are you looking at
Feb?
Are you looking at, do you guys talk about marriage? Do you joke about it? Because, you know, one time I was having a conversation with my boys,
yeah,
and they're like, if a guy really wants to have a future with you, he starts to tease, babe, when we are weak?
He does joke about it. I have,
and you both have babies, so you're sorted.
Oh,
you're planning on having one for him?
No, if we're together for a long time, why not?
One last thing. When it comes to, so many times when you post pictures, there's so many fans who comment about the way you dress, comparing the fact that you're a mother.
Yes.
They think you're really, really indecent.
For a mother.
Mm. So they start comparing you to Juliana, who also had RIP Karen, who also had a baby, and she dresses up like a mother. What you have to say, your baby is white, yes, we know. Are you very liberal with the way you live your life?
I think babies shouldn't change the way we dress. You understand? Because at the end of the day, it's your kid will do what you do. You understand? First they'll follow what you tell them, and then when they grow up, they'll basically go with those rules at the end of the day, you know?
Okay.
So when I am performing in front of my audience, those are not my children.
And before we wrap up this gossip,
yeah,
so apparently, mm-hmm, while you were at Karen's vigil, you and Ken were too much into each other that Halima came and said something. Apparently, everyone is trying to say, I think Yaya Bagamba Kubanange, calm down,
you need a room.
Are you going to share what Halima said?
Bambi, that's
what did Halima
true.
Say? Did Halima say that?
Okay, here's the thing. Halima is like a mother of all of us female artists,
yes,
in general. Now I'm never how she, you know, carries herself. So she's a kind of woman that I will go to, because my aunties are not so close to me.
Mm.
If I had an issue that needed an auntie, I would probably call Halima.
Oh,
you understand? And ask her, how would you go about the
situation?
Have
her on the
like,
show then, yeah.
She's that kind of woman. So when I saw her, I hadn't seen her in a long time since I met Ken. So I thought, okay. Let me introduce you.
Right?
Yeah.
It's
not like she, no.
Okay, fine. Now we know. I'm still with Cindy. We're at a Sun of Beauty Salon trying to get dolled up. It's at Kingsgate Mall, Kabalagala. Cindy has told you she's just 29 and she's still a baby. She loves Ken. She is in love, head over heels. What Fina is saying today, no, maybe Fina is in denial. We don't know. And she's saying, those allegations that when Mario was saying that maybe she wasn't good in bed, what was he doing there 10 years? Salon Talk.